so on and so forth. But we're not going to worry about those today. That's in the future. Okay. So, let's bring up this book here. And we'll show you some examples of what are grouches, what are quavers, and everything in between. Is a crotchet, and you know that because it has the stem going up. You see that? It's got the stem going up and no tail. There's no tail. This note, on the other hand, has a stem and then it has the tail coming down. Can you see that? So this is a quaver, and there are 8 quavers in a bar. This here, this thing that kind of looks like a little lightning bolt, this is a quarter note rest. It has the same value of a quarter note here, but you just don't play anything. I'll get into that a little bit more in a minute or two. This, what looks like a little number 7, this is a quaver. I'm used to working in quarters and eighths. This is a quaver rest. So again, it has the same value as a quaver with a tail, but you just don't play anything. So, you may be thinking, this is all gibberish. Yes, let me explain. So, there are 4 beats in a bar. Still need to account for all 4 beats. So as I explained before, a crotchet is worth 1 beat. So there are 4 crotchets in one bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how you would count that bar. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. concept of it. Okay. Okay, interesting. So, you actually see backwards, you see in reverse. I'm very impressed that you're getting this. Let me note that down. Sees in reverse. Very, very impressive. So when I show you this, you see it backwards. Very interesting. Well, then I'm extra impressed and you get a lot of brownie points for that, because that is tricky. Okay, let's go on to the next bar, shall we? On beat one, sleep pattern.